Hey everyone, I'm Alex.
And I'm Rachel.
Today we'll be talking to you about the 11th principle of green chemistry, real-time analysis for pollution prevention. This principle states that analytical methodologies need to be further developed to allow for real-time in-process monitoring and control prior to the formation of harmful substances.
In other words, it's important to have feedback in real time and design our experiments in a way that we can monitor them. While that may sound complicated, we actually already use real-time monitoring in many everyday tasks. For example, when you're cooking. Let's say you want to make a pot of chili.
When you're cooking chili, you continuously monitor the heat. Maybe you need to stir the chili as well with a wooden spoon to check the texture. Is the chili thick enough? Maybe you want to add more tomatoes, or maybe we need to add a little more water instead.
Maybe you want to give it a quick taste while it's on the stove. From there, you can determine if you need to add more salt or add more spices.
Monitoring your chili and receiving feedback in real time about its texture, heat, and taste makes it much easier for you to adjust your cooking while you're doing the cooking, and generally makes for a much tastier meal.
Having the tools for real-time analysis is important. When cooking chili, you need to have access to a stove or a hot plate. You also have to have your wooden spoon available to taste and stir, as well as your spices nearby and available.
Similarly, when chemists are planning a reaction, they make it a priority to design the reaction beforehand to minimize waste, hazards, and use efficient conditions. It's also important to design a reaction that can be easily monitored and receive feedback in real time to allow for adjustments.
Just as real-time feedback is needed in cooking, it is also essential to ensure that chemical processes are properly functioning.
A common chemistry example is neutralizing an acid, such as this dilute solution of acetic acid, or vinegar. We're going to be using some pH paper to determine the actual pH of your solution.
If the pH paper looks red or pink, the mixture is acidic. If the paper is orange, the mixture is neutral. If the paper is blue or green, the mixture is basic.
To neutralize this acidic solution, we're going to slowly add a base. In this case, we're going to add a dilute solution of sodium bicarbonate in water. As we add small amounts of base, we use the pH paper to check whether the mixture is acidic, neutral, or basic.
The pH paper provides analytical feedback in real time on how far along we are in the reaction. We may need to continue adding more base depending on what color the pH paper is. When the pH paper shows that the reaction is neutral, we can stop the reaction.
This is especially important when doing chemical processes on a massive scale, like in industry. There are several ways that large-scale processes are designed to let us obtain real-time in-process monitoring of a reaction.
For example, changes in temperature can be measured by internal thermometers, while changes in pressure are measured by barometers. There can even be frequent monitoring and adjusting of the pHs of solutions to maintain ideal reaction conditions. However, in industry, they typically use more sophisticated equipment than pH paper.
From a safety standpoint, we can also detect problems that may occur during a reaction and shut them down before any major incidents occur.
If you're interested in learning more about real-time analysis for pollution prevention, check out the description box below for a link to our blog post on Principle 11.
Be sure to like this video and subscribe to see the rest of our series on the principles of green chemistry. If you want to learn more about the Green Chemistry Initiative, check us out at our website or on Facebook and Twitter.